Learn about some of the performance gains you get with Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server, including a cool demo which also touches on maintenance windows, this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I have joined with me a special guest, Bashar, from the Azure Database for MySQL team. Bashar, thanks so much for joining us on the show today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Hi, Anna. Thanks for having me here. My name is Bashar, and I'm a senior product manager in the Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server team. My charter includes performance, maintenance windows, major and minor version upgrade, pricing, along with supportability of the product.
Awesome. Great. So it seems like you are the perfect person for what we're going to talk about today. We're going to be talking about some of these things related to performance. But before we get into it, I wanted to ask you, you know, why should customers that are either not using Flexible Server today or using Azure Database for MySQL single server, why should they consider using Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server?
So basically, Flexible Server was designed for providing more granular control for users over their database management operations and control. So basically, we've heard the feedback coming on the Azure single server, and we decided to build an architecture which offers the customer better performance, more granularity, and better management of this database server itself. So basically, a Flexible Server will come with a lot of features that customers will be looking for to have a better performance, predictability in terms of monthly maintenance windows, and along with co-location between database and application.
Awesome, cool. And if we wanted to go a little deeper, can you share with us how Microsoft went about actually building a more performant of this community open source MySQL?
Oh, that's a great question. So first thing for us was that we wanted to ensure that this will be an open source, fully open source database. So customers can easily migrate to the Flexible Server. On top of that, we've decided that we will reduce the number of hops between application and database. So we removed gateways in between the application and database. The application connects directly to the database. And also we allowed users to decide which availability zone they want their database and their storage to be in. And the Azure Virtual Machines also allows this capability. So basically, customers can locate their application, their database, and their storage in the same zone, which significantly reduce latency. On top of that, we decoupled the storage from the IOPS. So basically, in single server, if your workload requires more IOPS, you'd scale up storage, and then you'll get more IOPS. And basically, it was each 1 gigabyte, 3 IOPS. This offers a challenge for customers because by default, the community version of MySQL does not allow you to shrink files. So basically, you can scale up storage, you can scale down storage. And that was a huge limitation. So what we did, we decoupled storage files. If the workload requires more, it's IO intense workload, you just scale up IOPS and then you can later scale it back down. Another thing that we did, we decoupled the number of vCores from the max number of connections. So some workloads, some applications require higher number of connections to connect concurrently to the database server. And we decoupled those. So Flexible Server offers higher number of active connections simultaneously on the same server.
Cool, thanks. So if I could just recap, it really comes into two bigger things that kind of improve the performance. One is the ability to co-locate things in the same zone, which is actually huge because folks coming from on-prem or somewhere else are used to all these things being right next to each other. And now you can kind of do the same thing in the cloud by putting your VM, your app, and your database in the same zone. So that's awesome. Then the other thing I heard was around independent scaling. So now you have the ability to scale your compute, your IOPS, and other things really independently of one another without having to scale up vCores, for example, to get more users. So that's really awesome. I know you all are also doing some things in the maintenance window space. Could you share like a brief of what maintenance windows are and then also what's new for Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server?
Sure, that's a great question. So basically, Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server, as we say, fully managed database service, which means that we are giving a lot of background operations that we are helping users with. Basically, patching the servers with the latest and the greatest bits for the operating system, the database system. We're adding features, improving performance, along with other bits that we are shipping every month to ensure compliance, privacy, security for our customers. So basically all those operations needs to go in on the database, and the database requires a restart. So in single server, we used to send notification to customers 3 days ahead that there will be a restart on your server in the following 16 hours window. The restart will only take less than a second, maybe up to 3-4 seconds. Really depends on the transactions that the user is running. The problem with this feature that some customers would have like a workload that they need to run during those 16 hours window, so it reduces the predictability for them. Now, in flexible server, the cool thing is that the customer can decide a custom window, the day of the week that they need this patch to happen in, and only 1 hour window. So they will go on Friday midnight, and the restart will happen during this hour. The also what we are shipping with the maintenance windows for flexible server are version upgrades. So we're taking care of those for the users, along with the capability for the customer to decide if they want to pause or they want to resume or like the maintenance to happen. So this gives more flexibility to the users that they can decide when to patch their servers with the latest bits.
Gotcha. So flexible server isn't just about flexibility when it comes to performance, but also flexibility, playing on that flexible word, for things like maintenance windows. So it's really awesome to hear all the stuff happening in the MySQL space here. I think you might have a demo. It would be awesome to kind of see some of this in action.
Right. So just before I play the demo, there's one thing I would like to point out. So in flexible server, there are three performance tiers for users, burstable, general purpose, and memory optimized. The ability for flexibility gives the customer so many combinations, and they can choose which performance tier they want to run on. Basically, burstable SKUs are for workloads that will not require full CPU all the day, so they can use the bursting of CPU. General purpose is better for workload, which is like mid-tier workload, balance between the vCores and the memory with a scalable IOPS. So if they are a little bit more IO intense, they can go higher with the IOPS with the same memory and vCores, CPU processing. Now for the memory optimized, they will get tier one workloads, which require more in-memory operations. So this will be really cool because they can balance between in-memory operations and IO intense workloads. And now I think we can go to the demo. I'll show the differences in terms of throughput, latency between single server and flexible server. So basically this is the workbench. I'm running workbench from this West2S2 VM, and it has a 8V core and a 32 gig memory. This is the single server, which we are running on, same 16V core. And in basically this single server that I'll show, it's in West2S2, okay? And as you can see here, 16V core, and it has 8 terabyte and 20,000 IOPS. So basically, you can go all the way to 20,000 IOPS. For this test, I did 20,000 IOPS just to get the more IOPS, but you can scale up and down storage. Basically, storage and IOPS are related here because it's a single server. Now, this is the flexible server, and this has also 16V core and same memory, 8 terabyte for storage, and it's running in West2S2. And if you look at compute and storage, here you have IOPS slider, so I'm all the way to 20,000 IOPS, but storage, I can decide how much storage I want. So this is a better performance price. Now, if you look at the workbench that I just ran before this demo. So basically for 360 seconds, I'm 250 threads concurrently. And as you can see here on the single server, I was able to get around 8K, so 64K, sorry, QPS per second. Basically, the latency was around 632 milliseconds. So now if we are trying to compare with the flexible server, running the same test, 360 seconds, 250 threads, and same server that I just showed you, basically here we were able to get 115K QPS per second, which is a huge gain compared to the single server for the same SKU. And the latency was much, much lower for 43, thanks for the colocation. Now, if you look back, 64K and 632 on the single server. So it's a huge gain because of the colocation and the performance updates that we have done. Now, talking about the maintenance window, as you can see here, in terms of state maintenance, the customer can choose between system managed schedule and the custom schedule. The custom schedule, you can choose the day of the week. So if you, as I said before, you can choose which day of the week you want to run the maintenance in, and then just click on the day and then decide the time that you want the, you know, the maintenance to happen in, and click save, and that would save the maintenance. You have predictability in terms of when the maintenance will happen.
Awesome. Cool. That's a great demo, Bashar. It was really cool to see how much the performance improves. And then also how you were able to put the things in the same zone, put the database, I'm sorry, in the same zone as the VM that you were running the test in, which probably also, I'm guessing, was a big factor in improving the latency there. Sure. So, Bashar, as we kind of close out this video, do you have any final words of advice or tips and tricks for folks that are just getting started with Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server?
Yeah, sure. So basically, we are doing our best to send all the tips and tricks for the Azure Flexible Server on our blog. So please follow our blog channel. We are posting a lot of hacks and tips, tricks to get better performance. And as I said, Flexible Server offers a lot of flexibility to customers, which makes sometimes in scenarios where which is the best one to go for. So we will have all those in our blogs. And enjoy using Flexible Server. And thank you so much for considering Azure Database for MySQL Flexible Server.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Bashar. And thanks to our viewers for tuning in. If you like this video, go ahead, give it a like. Check the links in the description, including the blog for the Flexible Server team. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.